time to soak up the beauty of the day with Florence Price's Dawn's Awakening. Hello and welcome back to Meet Mozart. I'm Angie. That's Mozart. And before we hop into the music, we're going to do a little bit of a tour of history. So Florence Price was born in 1887 in Little Rock, Arkansas, and she was actually a child prodigy. She gave her first piano recital at the age of 4 and had her first piece of music published by the age of 11. By 14, she was attending New England Conservatory, and her mother encouraged her to tell everyone that she was of Mexican descent instead of African American descent so that she could get into the school. And she did, and she thrived. And once she graduated, she moved back to the South and began teaching there, teaching music in a lot of black universities. Racial tensions in the South, however, were very high. And after a lynching that actually happened near her husband's work, she and her family decided to move to Chicago in 1927. Shortly after their move, her husband became abusive, and so they divorced. And so now, as a single mother, she had to take on every type of musical odd job she could get her hands on. So she worked writing radio ads. She also played for showings of silent movies. And she also began to compose. And it wasn't until she had broken her ankle that she actually got the downtime she needed in order to finish her first symphony. She submitted the symphony to a competition and won and became the very first African-American woman to have her music played by a major orchestra, which was the Chicago Symphony. Throughout her lifetime, she wrote more symphonies. She also wrote lots of concertos and sonatas, beautiful piano pieces, and even some art songs, and of course, a lot of spirituals. One of the really beautiful things that's apparent in Price's music, especially through her use of rhythms and her leaning on spiritual folk tunes, is a really beautiful sharing of the Black experience in America. She became a part of a lot of African American music communities and got to know people like Langston Hughes and Marian Anderson, who was a very famous contralto at the time. And Marian Anderson very historically presented a recital outside the Lincoln Memorial in Washington, D.C. And at the time, D.C. was segregated, so they wouldn't allow Anderson to perform inside the halls. So they set up this performance outside, and Eleanor Roosevelt was in attendance, and she finished her recital with one of Price's spirituals. And she continued to really champion Price's work throughout the rest of her lifetime. Price passed away in 1953, and if you want to know whether or not her music has stayed in circulation since then, unfortunately, it depends on who you ask. It stayed quite alive in the black community, but in the mainstream classical community, it certainly took a dip. But it's enjoying a resurgence these days due to a couple things. First of all, there's been a really big push and movement in the classical music world to present more works by women and people of color and really become a more inclusive environment. But it's also due to the fact that in 2009, they discovered a bunch of her piano music manuscripts in her home outside of Chicago, a summer home of hers, and it was discovered by two of the new homeowners. So in the last few years, we've really gotten to get to know more and more of her beautiful music. Price's song, Dawn's Awakening, is one that it seems we don't have a whole ton of information about regarding what specifically inspired her to set this poem by James Joseph Burke, who we also don't seem to have a ton of information about. But I just want to open up the floor that if anyone does know a little bit more of the story and the background of this song, we'd love to hear it. So feel free to comment with that in the comments. But I do think it's a song that shows some really beautiful themes that Florence Price revisits quite a lot in her music. First of all, in a lot of her piano music, many of the titles go around themes that are like honeysuckle at dusk, and that are sort of meditations on nature and a singular moment. And so in this song, with this poem, we have a speaker who's taking in and observing every moment as night transitions into day and watching the world awaken. And so that fits really beautifully with this theme that she's really played with a lot in her piano music. The other theme that this piece touches on is a reverence toward God. And of course, we really get that through all of her amazing spirituals, but it's actually quite present in a few of her art songs as well, including this one. And what's interesting about the way that she approaches that is that, you know, this song is set in a strophic style. And by strophic, I mean we've got two verses in the poetry, and musically, we have the same musical setting for both verses, more or less. There are a few changes, but it's pretty much the same for both verses, which sort of poses a difficult task for a composer because, as we all know, the verses are different and the emotional weight of the things that we are seeing as the world awakens are very different. So how do you set that the same musically but still bring out all of these different moments in a unique way? And one of the things that I really love about what she does is she sets up a beautiful parallel between the sun in the first verse and the church in the second verse. And the way that she sets that musically is like this. Let me just show you real fast. It's a very, very simple little counter melody and harmonic progression. And sort of, it kind of sounds like nothing on its own. But when you hear it in the context of the music around it, where we're coming from and where we're going, you just get a sense of something very clear and very pure. And in that sense, you get really a beautiful parallel that perhaps Price was viewing both the rising of the sun and that little church as sort of a beacon of hope. So without further ado, we're going to introduce you to Florence Price's Dawn's Awakening.
I stood on a hill at daybreak and watched the rising sun. I saw the night in its passing and the day that had just been.
Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please be sure to like, comment, subscribe, push all the fun buttons, including that little notification bell. And please take an extra moment to check out the details in the description below. I'm going to leave a couple great things for you there. One of them is going to be a link to where you can actually purchase this collection of her songs and spirituals. It's not, you know, something you just find on Amazon. So I'm going to put that down there. I'll also add a link to her first symphony that put her on the map, and also some really beautiful performances of her spirituals and a few of her other art songs. So I hope you take a look. It's definitely a YouTube rabbit hole that is worth going through, and it'll keep you busy until we see you next time. Bye.